Allah, please convey our heart's love and greetings to your beloved and to our beloved and to the means of attaining you and seeing you and loving you and the means to coming into to existence, to come to be. Oh Allah, bless Muhammad, the praiseworthy, the praiser, and his noble family and wives and children, descendants, companions, with your greatest manifestation of love and glory and beauty and everlastingness. Amin, 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 and tenderness and creativity, all the qualities that we desire ourselves to attain. So I thought I would continue today the generosity of Allah in the atom from the Sun of Knowledge and read something from a Heart of Quran, which seem to reflect each other and also bring in a tajalli from our brother Shwaib's talk this morning. So as we proceed in the Ramadan, we have this desire to embody more, to become closer, get closer to the essence, to the smell more of the fragrance, to be completely consumed and absorbed in divine praise and love. And so I pray that this may all happen for us. There is an inevitable drawing closer by Allah. We are drawn, but to be drawn, we need to be aware also. And for the lovers, it's awareness is a beautiful trait of love and of the lover. When in the hadith, when the beloved Abraham is consternated and troubled in his heart, and Allah comes upon him in a way, metaphorically speaking, in that state and says, "Oh, my friend, what is troubling you?" And then Abraham refers to the slip of his forefather Adam, alayhi salam, and says, "You know, for one moment of a mistake, look what happened to Adam." And then Allah says, "Yes, the ghafla, the inattention, the heedlessness, is a great error, is a great mistake for the lover." For the lover. So this is why, you know, someone like Musafir Effendi hardly slept, and he wanted to remain in that state of awakeness for his beloved and attentiveness, attending, serving. And we serve simply by being here, one, that's one level, present, alive, breathing and moving. And then we also serve in a closer way through being conscious. And the way of love is, you know, delicacy and consciousness. And sometimes, yes, it can be that great fire, blazing fire. But then the blazing fire kindles down into a very pure light of presence. So we were speaking yesterday because it was the day of Hazrat Aisha's Urs, the beloved Aisha, and of the intimacy cultivated between the blessed Muhammad and his beloved Aisha, peace be upon them both. And it's so remarkable that we actually have hadiths that revealed that. You know, that he was completely with Allah in his prayer and yet completely with his beloved, and prostrating in the bed where they slept, and she would draw her legs back, and then he would put his head on the ground, and then when he rose up again, she would stretch her legs out again. So if we can see that as such you know, I want to call it dance, but it's even maybe more inner, more subtle, a movement of lovers in this vortex of the divine heart. all with Allah. This is all with Allah. There is no, there was never a separate separation in that moment. So let's read a little more about, and so yes, what I want to say was, let's cultivate this in these last days, because probably we're already doing, you know, inshallah, fasting, or for those of us who can fast, or reading Quran, studying Ibn Arabi, offering tasbih, offering the wirds. So it's not clear how we could add more onto that, you know, except to be in a state of constant zikr. Yes. So la ilaha illallah, or Allah, Allah. Yes, that, and that's very easy in these latter days of the Ramadan to feel that. And so that is a constant praise of the beloved and a constant attention. Ramadan is the state of consciousness, here we are, in which the boundless generosity of essence displays itself openly. So what does that mean? It's always displaying itself. It means that we are aware of it. We become aware of it, or we could also say Allah removes veils over our heart. For an entire month, Ramadan generates a crystal clear reflection of paradise upon the mirror of the earthly plane. In this mirror of space and time shines precisely the same light of Allah that floods the seven heavenly planes and that surges within the divine heart. Ramadan opens the gates of paradise. Allah fully manifests paradise during the night of power, and the month of Ramadan is all night of power. A single diamond of divine peace and power, turning slowly, sunset by sunset, each of its 29 brilliant facets, a mystical night, during which unique blessings descend into the entire universe from the Most High, who is the most near. So right away, the attribute of exaltedness is countered with the attribute of nearness. So this is part of the bewilderment of the lovers. The central core of the month, the precise night of power, extends timelessly in earthly time from sunset to dawn. This mystical night, containing the golden midnight sunrise of essence. So this is beautiful, this mystical night containing the golden midnight sunrise of essence, actually dissolves and resolves galaxies and subtle heavenly worlds into pure paradise. So we don't know how that happens. He's saying here resolves or dissolves, but it's a divine, that only the divine transformer, Ya Mukallib al-Qulub, can bring about. Paradise is not a physical, mental, or spiritual location within creation, but the very heart of the Creator. Thus, Ramadan reveals in daily experience, whether to advanced mystics or to beginners in the way of Islam, the inconceivable identity of the primal essence, the divine attributes, the eternal souls, and the pristine creation. So I'd like to read that again. Thus, Ramadan reveals in daily experience the inconceivable identity of the primal essence, the divine attributes, the eternal souls, and the pristine creation. This supreme identity or indivisible unity is prior to and beyond the mystic union of the soul with its Lord. Prior to and beyond divinity and humanity, creator and creation. For these dynamic polarities are simply the play of divine energies. The night of power is the perfect peace in which all dynamics disappear. O night of power, please manifest continually as the very nature of reality. Amen. As the very nature of infinite generosity. Amen. As the very nature of the fully evolved Muhammadan humanity. Amin. Alhamdulillah. Rabbil alamin. Mashallah. Alhamdulillah. 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 So the night of power is this ultimate unity, this essence that is all, that is the attributes are nothing but this essence of the heart of the Creator, this essence of love. So I think if we could invite ourselves to this level, so I would say that the latter part of Ramadan to use as the time of contemplation, and this is also why we retreat to be with Allah into the mosques, into the homes in the last 10 days, so that we can cultivate contemplation, also contemplation and prayer, and be guided and supported with these exalted visions. And similar to this is what our brother Shuaib said at the end of our meeting on Ibn Arabi, rahmatullah alayh, is that only Allah sees Allah, and Allah, and then he reversed it, Allah sees only Allah. So I would say that if we can make this the intimacy of the Prophet and his beloved Aisha in that moment of being in the inner chamber of love, on the bed of love, and he's praying to his Lord, and his beloved is, in a sense, wrapped around him, is surrounding him, so with the fragrance of love, contemplating this essential wisdom of only Allah sees Allah, only Allah knows Allah, only Allah loves Allah. That's what I would say would be a great, great, great last portion of the Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Ooh, thank you. Oh Allah, oh beloved, guide us even closer than you have guided us before, oh Allah. And may we live in the state of unity. May we see that your essence, your attributes, your actions, ourselves are all this oneness. May we die to separation. May we die to a sense of our own agency as doers, oh Allah. May we become purely the open space and ground of your magnificence, of your being, of your beauty, of your love, oh my God, of your loving yourself, oh Allah. May we be this point in between your love and you loving yourself, oh Allah. And may we be like in the Ayatul Nur, that the light, the glass, the flame, all become one. When the light radiates, we see no separation, and we see no separation between the light and the blazing of the light and the twinkling of the light, oh Allah. Please lift us to this state of clear seeing, the seeing that our beloved guide and master Sayyidi Rasulullah speaks of, and he says, I stand on clear seeing, myself and those who are with me, those who follow me. May we be granted this gift in the Ramadan, and may we see that the love and the seeing are one, and the love and the being are one, Allah, and the love and our lives and what we see as ease and what we see as tribulation, may we see that now as one. May we make no difference, Allah. May we all see it as radiance of you, as your love, your kindness and mercy, overflowing everywhere, your boundless generosity, and may we be this refuge of the Ahad, Kulhu Allah, Kulhu Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samed. May we be that refuge, that place of manifestation for your ahad, all your beautiful names, O Allah, and may we dwell with you and through you and from Amen. You and within and without and always on your side forever and ever eternally and subsist with you. Ameen. And may all humanity, all creatures, all being be drawn into this unity of absolute mercy.
Ameen.
Absolute mercy. Ameen. 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 O Allah, please heal our bodies, heal Ameen. Our minds, heal our hearts, O Allah.
Ameen. Ameen.
Bring us back to you, Ameen, in everything we do. Ameen. Through the secret heart of our peers, our prophet, our beloved. Muhammad, Muhammad, all praise, praising, all praiseworthy. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in. Ihdina Sirata Mustaqim. Sirata Ladina An'amta Alayhim. Qayrim maqdubi alayhim walatoneen. Ameen. Ameen. As we go toward transparency in these latter days of the Ramadan, the love intensifies. So the radiance increases, the light and through the glass shines so bright that the glass disappears. The niche disappears, alhamdulillah, in the radiance of love. So thank you. Thank you, thank you. Beautiful to gather in this Juma. Let's offer a Fatiha for that quest, for that longing to be elevated and transformed into dissolved and recomposed with the cells and atoms and molecules of love and clarity and transparency. May we pray for that. And may we pray for that for all who long for that. And may we pray for goodness for all who long for goodness. And may we pray for increasing knowledge for all who long for increasing knowledge and nearness for all who long for nearness and for health for all who long for health and for peace for all who long for peace and for restoration of human relationships. Oh Allah, please. So restoring the divine relation among us all and with our partners, our families, our neighborhoods, our larger societies. We beg you for restoring this, inshallah, that we may all together live this life as the holy way of life and joyfully and praisefully, forgetting ourselves, dissolved into you. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Returned through you the secret heart of our peers, a Fatiha. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, wa ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa sallim wa sallim. And nourishment for those who need nourishment, food, basic, healthy, wholesome food, and clean air and clean water, and pure guidance, good guidance, and clear thoughts. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka Na'budu wa Iyyaka Nasta'in. Ihdinas Sirata Mustaqim. Sirata Ladina An'amta Alayhim. Ghayril Maghdubi Alayhim Walad-Dhalin. Amin. Amin. Alhamdulillah. 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 MashaAllah.